Hi guys, welcome to another video on the Python tutorial series for beginners on my channel, Code with Tommy. In the last video, we talked about different functions in Python, but we didn't go deep into the functions. So today we are going to go deeper and talk about math functions in Python. Now, what does math function do? They just perform different basic arithmetics, and some are not basic, some are more complex arithmetics. It's just cool. Let's dive straight into it. With this, you can, let's first start by just printing, adding up two values. You can just print 2 + 3. Sorry for that. You can just print 2 + 3. Now, when we print this, it should give us 5. See it here. It gives us 5. That's how simple it is. We can subtract two values. Let's say 2 - 1, and this should give us 2 - 3, should give us -1. It's so accurate, it's like a calculator. We can multiply two values. Just want to take you guys through everything. Now you see this give us 6. This is it here. And also we can divide two values. Now let me say 2 / 2. Because I don't want no straight number. Now it gives us 1.0. Now this takes us to our next function. You see, it gives us 1.0. If we want to get the results in just one, we don't want 1.0, we want a normal string. That means we want to get the absolute value. Now what we are going to do for that is we'll do this. Before we write 2 / 2, we'll do ABS. And then we're going to do 2 / 2. Now let's see if that works. Okay, obviously that didn't work. Now what I think is the problem is because this is a float. It's a float number. 1.0 is a decimal number. So I think we are going to have to convert it to integer. Now if I do something like this, let's see. Now you see that it gives us 1. That's basically what it does. And now let's say we want to write a function which shows us the remainder of a division. Now let's say we do 7 / 2. You know this will give us 3, remainder 1. It give us 3 points. Okay, it gave us int because we told it give us the absolute value. But let's remove that now. But it give us 3 points something. It gives us 3.5. Now if we want to get the remainder of a division, what we're going to do is we just print 7 instead of saying ÷2, we'll print 7%2. Now you see this give us 1. That means when we divide 7 by 2, it gives us 3. What the remainder is 1. Now if we say 6 / 2, it gives us 3 with no remainder. So this should print 0. You see that it gives us 0. Very simple. Now if we want to convert a number to a string, let's say we want to convert 3. 3 is obviously an integer. We want to convert it to a string. What we're just going to do is str, then this, then write your apostrophe, then write 3. This will just print out 3. But now, this doesn't see it as a numerical value anymore. It sees it as a text. Now, we try to add this up. It won't work. Let's test this out by first defining a variable. Let's say our variable is num string, let's put it like this. Then let's say is this. Now let's first give it a normal number. Sorry for this. Let's just say this is num. Then now let's say num string. That means num converted to string. Let's now say str num. Now you see we've converted this to a string. Now let's say we want to add up two numbers. We can say 3 + num string. Now this will give us a bad error. You see that it said unsupported operand types. That means you can't add an integer and a string. But now when we just cancel this, remove it, don't convert it to a string, and just print num, 3 + num, it should give us 6. You guys see that here down below, it gives us 6. Now that's very cool. Now we also want to do some other cool functions related to numbers. Now let's say we have minus 5 or minus 10, but we don't want to print any minus or plus attached to it. We just want to print it out as a plain number. We can just do print. Let's say we have a number which is minus 11. Now when we print num, it gives us minus 11. But if we want to remove that minus, we'll just do abs num. Now this will give us 11. It gives us the absolute value. Okay, what does it say? Okay, we forgot to add a bracket here. Now when we print this, it gives us 11. Now that's very cool. Now let's say we want to get the power, like when we do 3 raised to power 2, 6 raised to power 4, something like that. Let's cancel all this and just, it's so simple, we just print power of, let's say 5 raised to power 2. This is how you write the syntax. Now when we print this, it should give us 25. Okay, it says name power is not defined. Okay, now there are some math functions which you need to import before using it. Like, see this error it has been giving me here. It says I need to install pylint, but I'm not going to install it now because it will need a restart. So there are some math function in which you need to import the math class, but let's keep that and go. But I'm just showing you guys that this is how you find power. Once you import, I will show you how to import the math class at the end of this video. Now, if you want to get the highest value in a list of numbers, we can just print max and put brackets. Then let's say we have 4, 5, 11. Now, what this will print out for us is 11. You see this? It gives us 11. It shows us that 11 is the highest number in this list of values. Also do the same to print out the minimum. We just change this max to min, shortening for minimum. Now you see that gives us 4 right here. That shows that 4 is the minimum value in that list. Now let's say we want to estimate a number, I want to round up a number. Like, I'm sure you guys that have done math, you understand the meaning of estimation, estimation, approximation. Now if we want to round off, let's say want to round off 3.2 or 3.5, we do print round 3.5. okay, I wrote 4, my bad. Now it gives us 3. That means when you round off 3.4, it gives you 3. If we change that to 3.5, obviously it should give us 4. You see that here? It gave us 4. That's basically what we can do. And I told you guys that I'm going to show you how to import the math class. Now to do that, you can, when you import the math class, you can have access to a ton of math functions. To do that, just say from math import please. Now I wrote from instead of from. Please don't make any mistake. It's sensitive. Now I know I've not told you guys about module libraries. I'm sure that looks strange to you, but later in the series I'll explain the meaning of importing classes, importing modules, importing libraries. But for now, just stick to this from math import asterisk. This means from the math class, built-in math class of Python, import all the functions from it. Now when we've imported this, we can find the square root of a number. Let's say we want to find the square root of 25. We'll just say print sqrt 25. Now when we print this, it should give us 5. It gave us 5.0. now I told you guys how to remove this 0.0. That's an assignment for you. You guys remove the 0.0. So you guys, thank you for watching this video. I really appreciate it. I appreciate your support. If you like this video, please don't forget to smash the like button and please subscribe and press the notification bell so you get notified when I release a new video. And if you have any question, please drop it in the comment and answer all questions. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.